Hi Pisces, welcome to Higher Source Tarot for your weekly tarot check. This is for the week of April 18th through April 25th for all Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. If you are new to the channel, welcome to you. I post new readings every Friday, then again on Monday. So if a reading doesn't resonate, you can check back in a couple of days. You could watch a reading from a different part of your chart. Or you can even look around on Mondays, because the Monday readings are a different format every week. So there may be something there too for you that you haven't seen before. Thanks to everybody who's been subscribing and hitting that like button. I really appreciate you and your support. And this is fun. We'll keep doing it. Whoops, I had a card come out. Put that over there. And if you haven't subscribed yet, I'd love to invite you to join us and subscribe. Let's begin here. Cards are ready. All right, what guidance do you have for Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus? What does Pisces need to know, please? Messages do you have for Pisces, please? All right, so we have the World coming out. That's always a good card to have show up, especially on its own, right? It just comes flying out of the deck. You begin here with the Two of Swords, the Moon, the Ace of Swords, the Three of Wands, the Two of Pentacles, the Sun, the Five of Wands. Haven't seen that in a while, and the Fool. Well, you've got your own energy here. We have Pisces, we have Leo here. Four major arcana. You've got Fire, Aries, Leo, Sag. You've got Air, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. And you do have Earth here too, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Well, it's interesting that you have the Sun and the Moon together, isn't it? We have to point this out. You got the Sun and the Moon always mirrors the Sun, but you also have the World here that shows up and brings in this awesome new phase and a new cycle. So some exciting things and developments are here. Now, the World is all about self-mastery. It's nirvana. It's getting to that place where you say, this was what it was all about, you know? It's like every little bit of struggle you went through, the pain, the paying the price of contrast, you expanded through that awareness. And it's really getting to that place where if you went through school, you get the job you've always dreamed of, right? You've had a number of failed relationships, and this is the one that it finally makes sense. You finally found somebody that gets you. You know, she dances in this wreath of victory. And what's interesting, so the Fool starts the journey, and the World then is that pinnacle. So when the Fool has achieved all that the Fool desires on this journey, that's when the Fool meets the World. It is a very centered state of emotional well-being. You're open to the universe here. It's, like I said, about completing a cycle and a phase ending. It's feeling amazing, though. So for some of you, this can indicate travel. It can indicate just feeling free. But it also, too, like I said, it's this new beginning. I do feel like you've got with the Fool here, this opportunity to have a brand new beginning. And it's wonderful. It's a rebirth, a complete rebirth. So the Two of Swords may have you feeling a little bit stuck. So you're going, yeah, bring on the World. I'm sick of this crap. You know, it's feeling like caught between two people or a situation where you feel put in the middle of something. And so you may have to make a choice here of just saying, I'm not Switzerland. I'm not in the middle. I don't want to be this, whatever you're trying to make me be. Some of you may be having a hard time making a decision about something here too. So they tell you to open your eyes, you know, but it's not just your eyes through your physical body. Open your heart, open your mind. When we go through life with a noisy mind and an armored heart, we stay really isolated that way. And so it's really about allowing yourself to be open to some new possibilities here. You have a beginning, a new beginning with somebody here in love, whether it's a reconciliation you've been waiting on or it's something brand new and you've just been waiting either way. So the Moon is that beautiful pool of consciousness. It reminds us that everything begins with the soul. It's all about the soul on this journey. And so you have a new phase with this. And so it's all about setting your intentions, being very clear about what you want, especially with that Two of Swords here, because the universe always hears you and your heart whispers the truth. And so if your mind says one thing and your heart says another, you're going to get what your heart desires, whether you want it or not in the ego sense. Okay. So with this, it's about, I feel like too, on a more mundane level for some of you with this Ace of Swords, I feel like somebody's really doing like a cleansing diet. They're doing like a big full detox thing, really doing a physical reset back to the basics. And maybe it's just about eating very simple, like not processed stuff, getting back to the basics, but feeling really physically good, especially with this Ace of Swords here. It's a card of great focus, mental clarity, but communication too. So I do feel like you're going to get communication on a relationship. And it's somebody who doesn't play games. And they're not cold, even though the Ace of Swords can kind of seem that way. It's not that way. They're just clear about what they want. And I feel like they're actually warm. They might be a Leo. They've got this warm vibe about them, but they just don't want to hurt anybody. They don't want to play games and mess around. So those of you that are, if it's a reconciliation or it's a new love, it's very straightforward. It's really no nonsense, but there's love, okay? So I don't want it to sound like it's just this aggressive thing. It really is just, like I said, this no nonsense thing that I think you're gonna find refreshing. You know, and this card too brings in these yods, the little yellow droplets. They're the first letter of the name of God in Hebrew, and you also have it here too. They're gifts. You've got gifts coming in from the universe. So your energy is light, it's easier. It gives you the relief or the release from that Two of Swords. So the Three of Wands is a card of waiting, but this waiting without being frustrated or anxious. It's a waiting with a knowing. It's a card of success and progress. So some of you are seeing hints of progress. So if it's your detox, you may say, God, I'm sleeping so much better. I stopped drinking Diet Pop and I just, God, I don't wake up like I used to. It was awful. You know, or maybe you've done some other things that are just resetting you physically and you are starting to feel really good. There's progress here. In terms of the work money life too, there's progress moving forward in things. And so it does feel like you're focused on other stuff right now though in this reading. But overall, it's such a good energy that it in some ways, if it's love, that really is your predominant thing. That's such a high vibration that, you know, when you're really head over heels with somebody, the rest of it kind of just seems to come into form. It doesn't seem to be, you know, other areas of your life don't seem to really matter that much. So the Two of Pentacles is a balancing act. It's a very busy energy. So you may find that you get focused on other things, and it helps a lot with that Two of Swords. So you don't get so much caught off, you know, into the thinking realm. This is more about lightening things up, being a little bit easier about things. There is money coming in here though, too. So some of you may get some extra little money here or there, and it just allows you an avenue into having more fun. You may find you don't do anything necessarily fiscally responsible, but you are responsible in the way that you have fun with it. And so it just brings joy and that lifts your vibration. And you say, I'm okay doing this because it makes me happy. And I know when I'm happy, I'm attracting other situations that will continue to create that happiness. It's just very easy. So we love to see the sun, right? I mean, we had quite a few different cards here, but you see this beautiful sun, fool, and world combination. I mean, it is revolutionary. It's an amazing energy field that you're walking into. I hear the song Walking on Sunshine. I think it's Katrina and the Waves. Remember that one? It's pure positivity. You know, it's hell yes. It's joy. It's enthusiasm. It's a zest for life. It's feeling renewed. It's feeling that sunlight of the spirit on you. And, you know, the sunflowers, I always like to point those out in the back. They point themselves towards the sun, but when the sun goes down, they point towards each other. You have some very supportive people around you. They want to see you win. They want to see you happy, waving that banner of victory. You've got the wreath and the banner here, both times. You've got it. And so it's feeling victorious over anything in the past that caused pain and even suffering. It's getting out of that cycle into something that is. You're clear-headed, you see where you're going, you see where you've been, and you're moving forward in a place that is drawing you. It's like this magnetic energy, vibrant energy drawing you, and you're attracting a lot of attention too. And I do think with that, although it's fairly minor, this Five of Wands, sometimes when you attract energy, a lot of attention, it can also attract some competition. Okay, so there may be people who are more competitive with you at work too. I see it at work. I don't see it with a relationship necessarily. For some of you, this also can be on the, again, that mundane level, even going out and watching kids play sports. You know, maybe you're at a park and you've got a kid who wants to go play soccer or go play basketball, and you're just there and you're in the moment and you're happy. You're just feeling the joy of the journey and just saying everything is right in the world. Okay, so this doesn't always have to be drama. It is a change card, but it also, like I said, it literally represents kids playing. So I do feel for somebody, it's a literal interpretation of this, which doesn't happen that often. But I think it's important to mention. So who's ready for a transition that brings in enthusiasm, trust, and new beginnings? Because you got one coming. The Fool is taking that leap of faith. He's on this spiritual quest, this spiritual journey. And it's like opening your eyes for the first time in this place, that magical place that we call our Earth School. You're ready to take on anything, really, in this energy. It's like, bring it on, world. I can handle it. You know how to navigate contrast. You know how to raise your own vibration. And it feels robust. It's in this feeling of just wanting to move forward. There's nothing holding you back. So in work, it's moving forward with ease, with confidence. You know, the Fool can be kind of naive, but it's like that naivete that is, you can be somewhat envious of. He doesn't see anything negative. You release all resistance in this. In a relationship, it's taking a leap of faith, but it's a brand new beginning. And there's nothing holding you back. It's like you both go running towards this new beginning. And it's feeling overjoyed, especially with the Sun. There's not a downside. I will say, though, with the Fool, it also, the white flower represents integrity and honesty, and so does the little white dog. So it's really having positive people around you. And the Fool, he carries that little bag over his shoulder on the magic wand that's full of his experiences. So he knows the experiences are there, but he doesn't live in pain and sorrow. He moves forward and he moves through things with ease, with grace. So let's see about a timeline for Pisces here. Really nice reading, though. I enjoy this energy quite a bit for you. You have here helpful people. So we saw that in the cards. There's definitely people showing up here that will be helpful to you on your journey. They may give suggestions or invite you somewhere new, and it ends up becoming one of those chance encounters. I also think, too, with the health and fitness stuff, you're going to have the right people that will give you great advice and answers. Meditation brings answers. So when the moon shows up, that's also a card of connecting with that soul level and meditation, quieting the mind. They say the situation will improve. So if there's something with that Two of Swords that you say, yeah, I know, I'm stuck here, I got to get past this. Well, it's coming. And you've got in the near future. Now you've got there's something better. So when you have there's something better, when you tell the universe, you communicate, you say this, there's something better. And I've seen it happen many times where somebody wants a specific car. They want this particular car. And the next thing you know, they get a better car. One that they thought was out of their range, but they got it at a, you know, huge discount. And they went, it's the same price. I can't believe this is my car. You know, it's that kind of stuff. This or something better. There's coming. It's coming for you, Pisces, and it's beautiful. So I love you, and I'll be back again soon.